Hey there, everyone. I hope you're rocking today. Being unemployed in geographic information systems sucks. You've probably got the skills. You've probably got the knowledge. You just don't got no job. However, in an interconnected world, you can increase your hireability by doing 5 simple things in the next 5 days, which is what I'm going to be talking about in this video. Before I get going, if you have any questions or any concerns or anything that you want me to talk about, just leave them down below. Let's get rocking. Hi there, I'm Dr. Chris, a professional geoscientist. Now, before we get going, you might see I've got new digs here. Got a green wall. This is only going to be for a few months. I may even be able to put in some cool special effects. Let's see how easy this is. Now, that either looked good or it looked like complete crap. Let's get back to the video. Being unemployed sucks, especially in a seemingly wide open discipline like geographic information systems. Whether you're a new graduate or a professional, finding employment feels like a drag. So, what happens when you can't find something? Well, there's some good news and there's some bad news. First, the bad news. Most people, when they're unable to find a job, start doing basic things like sending out resumes, which is good, searching the internet, which is good, but then they start doing unproductive things, such as watching too much TV, using social media for outrage, eating too much, getting depressed. You may even start questioning your career choices. Now, here is something more depressing that I gotta give to you right now. According to research, people will have forgotten 50% of what they've learned within 24 hours and forgot 90% within a month. This means if you're not actively using your education, you're going to forget what you have learned. It'll be less if you're a professional and have been working for a while, but you're still going to slowly lose what is in your mind. You're not going to keep up with new technologies. You're not going to make any new connections. You're going to fall behind. But as promised, there is some good news. No, there's some great news. I'm going to give you a few very basic steps to not only keep your skills ready, but to also make you 10 times more hireable in the next 30 days. These steps will only take you 1 or 2 hours a day. This means just watch one less TV show or no TV shows at all. The list looks like this, starting off with 1, read a blog post or listen to a podcast in GIS. These are great resources because someone has already done the work to distill a bunch of information that they're going to give you, chances are, for free to read or listen to. They'll talk about new technologies, new developments, upcoming conferences, who's who in the geospatial world. Blogs and podcasts are a massive resource that you can easily harness. And again, that is only 1 hour a day on day one to get started. 2, gather some related geospatial data. Now, it doesn't have to be a lot. It can be very basic, such as roads and regions in an area, borders and water courses, imagery and population statistics. I would suggest that you pick a small region, say a small state or a province. If you're doing this right, it should take you only about an hour to compile a good set of data, and this is just for day 2. 3, complete an analysis using that spatial data. You've got the GIS skills, now you can put it to use. If you've got roads and regions, you can see what percentage of roads are within each region. If you've got waterways and roads, now you can see what percentage of roads are within a certain distance of the waterways. If you've got population data, you can do populations within distance, within roadways, within waterways. This analysis is up to you, so bring out your creativity, and this is only 1 or 2, maybe 3 hours on day 3. 4, create a graphic. Since GIS is a visual medium, you can bring together your geospatial data, your geospatial analysis, and create a cool graphic from your analysis. It's very important that your graphic tells the story of your analysis and your geospatial data. Creating a graphic could actually take the longest of all the steps so far, because if you're like me, you like tweaking your symbology and making cool graphics that represent your analysis in the best possible light. And that's the end of day four. Number five, post your graphic to social media. This is the easiest step by far, but it takes a little bit of courage for you to show your work on social media. With hundreds of resumes out there, you have to be able to show what you can do fast. And social media is great for this. It's not only free, but if you do it right, you can brand yourself quite well. Here's a pro tip. Even if your graphic sucks, at least you put it out there for people to help you get better. That is the end of day five. You spent about 8 hours total. If you want to make this super powerful, you do it again and again and again and again. You'll keep up your analytical skills, your software use skills. You'd be showing off what you're doing and networking all in the space of 5 days. Those were my 5 steps on how to make yourself more hireable in GIS in the next 30 days. The steps are very basic and easy to repeat. Just listen to a podcast or read a blog, gather some spatial data, analyze some spatial data, create a graphic from that spatial data, and share your graphic on the internet. You'll be keeping your skills up and you'll be showing the world what you're capable of doing. Before I go, sign up for my newsletter at geographicinformationsuccess.com, where you can get some updates from me about how to make yourself more employable and how to have a better GIS. Also, I've got a Teespring store where you can get yourself some cool shirts, both in geoscience and in GIS. Thanks for watching. If you like this video, please give me a big thumbs up, subscribe to my channel, add me to your LinkedIn, or even better, share my videos through your networks. Till next time, I'm Dr. Chris. Keep rocking.